Hey guys, my name is Jason with Mount Baker Mining Metals, and on today's video we're back in the shop. We're going to be playing around with our rock saw. I've got some really cool, really special rocks that I'm going to be slabbing up today.
Here's a look at the victims today. This is a huge piece of gold ore from our gold mine, and as you've heard from me in the past, I believe this is one of the walls. The gold typically hangs out right along the wall, so we're going to try and get this in the saw and slab it up along this way. I don't know if this is another wall, so if this was the binding walls, foot wall and hanging wall, or vice versa, but I'm going to slab off some on this side too, and we'll see if we can see gold on either side. This is some really cool stuff that a friend gave me. This stuff has sapphires in it, and so they're little tiny blue, it's hard to see, but there's some blue sapphires right in there. Maybe if you use your imagination you can see them. So I'm hoping we can slab this guy up into pretty thin little sections and see that sapphire coming through if we get it, some light behind it. And then these three are nephrite jade that I got from the Fraser with Dan Hurd. So I'm going to be cutting these guys up and seeing what the jade looks like from the inside. And this one is a really, really pretty, really dark green color. Actually, all three of them are. So I'm really excited to get those cut up as well. I'm going to start with the sapphire rock. And I'll see if I can do this while you guys are kind of looking over my shoulder, and then take our slabs off of there. All right, this thing uses oil as a lubricant, so it's a little bit messy. That's why I'm wearing my gloves. This is a diamond blade, and it just goes real slow and worries its way through the rock. Sapphire is actually the mineral corundum, which is very hard. It's a 9 on the Mohs hardness scale. But diamond is a 10, and the difference between a 9 and a 10 is greater than the difference between a 1 and a 9. So the diamond should have any problem cutting through this. I'm gonna get the thing adjusted so we're right up against the blade. We'll close the lid, turn it on, and the rest is automatic. I'm not sure if you can see in there, but the blade is on the left. It's doing its thing, and there's the rock, and that whole vise and table and everything is just self-feeding through there. Oh, cool. We'll get him out in the light. Well, I don't know anything about the geology of sapphires, but I'm shocked there's so many sapphires in here. There's blue all through here, all the way along over here. There's a really nice big chunk right there. There's some down this way. So there, I thought there's gonna be like, oh, there's a little blue one there, there's a little blue one there, but there's just kind of almost a vein of sapphires right through here. I don't know how well this shows up in the camera, but let me try my microscope on this thing and see if the microscope gets a little bit better view of the blue color. Here's this little microscope we're gonna be using. I really like this thing. It clips right on my phone and it gets me 200 times magnification. So if you're interested in it, I got a link in the description for you. So here's a look close up. And all those kind of light blue things in there, I think are sapphire. Let's get over here. Yes, oh yeah, see there's some really good ones. I don't know, good ones, but a lot more blue. So there's definitely sapphires in here and a lot more than I thought there was gonna be. Here's one I'm just cleaning up, and there's just really nice deep blue sapphires all over it, especially up near the top third. I don't know if the sunlight's the best way to look at it. Maybe if I turn it like this, so it's backlit. See right there, those nice blue sapphires all across there? Man, that is cool. So this piece is 4 turns thick, which is about a 1/6 of an inch. And if you hold it up to the sun, you still can't really see through it. So I'm gonna try and go thinner, but this rock is just so opaque. Well, here's another one of our sapphire rocks, and this is about as thin as I can cut it. It's about 2 turns, or you know, maybe a 1/10 of an inch. and it's just so delicate, so fragile, I can't really do anything with it. And it's still, can't see through it, even against the sun. So it's just too dark of a rock to cut thin slices out of. But it's got some really nice blue sapphires in it. All right, I got this big bruiser clamped in there. I think I have enough height on the saw blade to make it work. We're gonna find out. But we're gonna run this through and take a couple slabs. Like I said, see if we can see any gold right here along this wall. Oh yeah, that works. Whoa, just barely. Just barely made that cut. Look at that. Very cool. All right, we're all reset. We'll take about an inch thick slab off of there. Here's that slab of gold ore. I am really impressed with this one. Watch what happens when I turn it into the light. Look right up here and right down here. See that? See the gold flash? That is amazing. There's gold down here. There's gold over here. There's some more smaller stuff. But when you can, I mean, I'm 2 feet away, and when you can see the gold flash in the sun at you, that's pretty impressive. The other thing that's surprising to me is I think these are chunks of wall rock, and I don't usually find gold right up next to the wall rock. Usually I would find it over here in these sulfide lenses, but I don't see any large gold over here in the sulfides. It's these two or three little pockets over here by the wall rock, so that's kind of unusual for me. That is just amazing, and it goes down into the quartz. You can see the gold kind of dendritic arms down into the quartz. This is the one that was farthest away from us when I showed it to you. Now let's see if we can cruise down here and find that other one. Here it is. Look at that one. Also, you can see it on the surface, but it goes down into the quartz there quite a ways, which is just awesome. There's the other little piece, just bright, shiny yellow gold right in the quartz, right next to the gray rock. I think those are wall rock chunks. There's a piece of sulfide. But man, it's just beautiful yellow gold. Well, my saw wasn't quite big enough. Oh boy. I just pop it down here and it'll break off. Let's see. Hey, that works pretty good. Ooh. That's pretty, but there's not a lot going on in there as far as mineralization. We'll have to take a closer look. Well, I've got these two little tangs here. Is this gonna work? That did okay. Any suggestions on how to do this would be appreciated. Let's see what our gold ore is looking like here. Oh yeah, see, I didn't have enough. Dang. I don't have enough blade height to make that work. Well, I don't really know where I'm going with this thing. I've got two parallel cuts now. When I knocked this off, the piece all fell apart, broke up into little pieces, and I didn't see any gold on this face. So now I'm not sure what I'm gonna do. I got these two. I'm just kind of whittling away at it now. I'm gonna cut a parallel side here, a perpendicular face. Maybe I'll turn it into kind of a big, huge cube or something. I don't know. We'll see how it goes. The problem is this takes forever to get through this. It takes like more than half an hour for each cut, so it just takes a long time, but it's going to be, whatever it comes out of, it's going to be pretty cool. Well, we're getting somewhere with this quartz ore block here. I've got three sides smooth in both ends, so I'm going to turn it one more time, take this off nice and smooth, and we'll have a gold pillar, gold ore pillar. And we're gonna clean up this end. That corner's broken, so I'm just gonna clean right up through there. And we'll have our finished up gold ore pillar. See what we got here. Cool. Big gold ore block. Now we're gonna start on our jade here. I guess I'll start with this big boy. We'll get him clamped in. And again, I'm gonna cut some really thin slabs to start out with and see if I can get them so the light can shine through them. Okay, we got her clamped in there. I'm gonna start slabbing it this way. Let's see how this goes. Yeah, that's gonna be pretty stuff. Look at the color of the rock. Now it's got the oil on it. Nice. Okay, let's do this. We'll crank it over. 1, 2, 3, 4. And we'll cut a fairly thin slice out of it. Let's see if we can get some light through it. Well, here's my piece with 4 turns of the vise. And it's pretty thin. I think it's less than a quarter. But I still can't see any light through it. Right on the edge, maybe. So this next one we'll do 2 and see if we can get a real thin sliced piece. But man, it's really, really dark inside. Really, really dark green. Well, I was looking in this light, this flashlight, and it actually does come through it. 4 turns. Look at that pretty dark green color. So this next one should be really translucent. Well, here's our little wafer thin piece of jade. Look at that, just very, very thin. But look at it against the light. That's cool. Let me get all the oil off it here. Beautiful, beautiful piece of rock. Look at that. I don't know, does this work? Very cool. It's interesting how it's not all uniform. It's darker in the middle and way more transparent out on the right side where I'm holding it. Here's the final haul. I've got our sapphire stuff here. There's one rock I didn't cut. But once I got to the, found out I couldn't see the light through them, I just cut that piece into kind of a little puzzle there. So that's kind of cool. Got some bookends or something. And then this gold ore stuff, man, I got all kinds of pieces. I got our stand-up gold pillar there. These are the coolest pieces, I think. You've got this matchbook or book matched with the gold in the face on both of them. That's awesome. Then look in the back, you got all these gold ore stand-ups, I think they're called. They're rough on the back side and then smooth cut on the face. A couple more of them up there, a little more rusty ore. And then we've got the jade over here. The thin pieces I cut that you can see through. And then I cut that one piece into 3 little stand-ups. I cut the one boulder rock into just 2 halves. That's kind of cool. And then I got one here that I didn't cut at all. So that's a quick rundown.
Well, I'm having so much fun with this rock saw, cutting all this different stuff, checking out what's inside these rocks. I wanted to give a huge thank you to my patrons. You are the reason why I'm able to buy this rock saw, and with your support, we're doing all this cool new content and cool new stuff. So if you're interested in supporting us, check out our Patreon page. And I also wanted to say that all this stuff is for sale on eBay, so check out our eBay listings. I'll put a link in the description below to both our eBay listings and our Patreon page. So thanks you guys for watching, thanks for all your support, and we'll see you on the next video.